on what you're saying, you're basically saying that if the president orders the military to stage a coup, you believe the only remediation for that is that he can be impeached or that Congress can restrict the budget?
Well, Caitlin, first of all, you're dealing with hypotheticals here that are completely outside the bounds of this particular situation. Donald Trump did not order a coup, despite the fact that a lot of media people say that he did, on January the 6th. He encouraged people to protest peacefully.
What's up, YouTube? Hope you guys are feeling good. Today, guys, we're back giving to a new video. Today, we're going to check out Collins praises J.D. Vance on whether he would be Trump's VP. Okay, this is going to be amazing. I would love to check this video out with you guys. I'm a big fan of J.D. Vance, and I just want to watch this video because out of curiosity, let me see how it turns out to be. Let's get right into this video.
You're a Yale-educated attorney, and I want to get your take on what we saw happen last week, those immunity arguments before the Supreme Court, where Trump's team, his attorney, argued that a president could order the military to stage a coup and to have their political opponent assassinated and be immune from prosecution unless this theory that they were impeached and then convicted by the Senate. Do you share the view that presidents are basically above the law?
Look, Caitlin, I think we have to be careful about imputing words into the president's attorneys that they didn't actually say. What the president's attorney said is that what the president's attorney said, Caitlin, to be clear, is that there is a checks and balances system in our Constitution. Now, some things the president does, private acts, are liable to criminal penalties. But most of the things that the president does in their official duties, we have a system of impeachment. We have a system of checks and balances, the legislative branch that I'm a member of, the judicial branch. I did not read the president's attorneys as saying that the president could order a coup. The president's attorneys are saying that the constitutional checks and balances system would address that problem.
And I
think that's
an
important distinction.
But let me stop you right there, because I listened to this. It's John Sauer, Trump's attorney. And when he was asked by one of the justices if the president could order the military to stage a coup and would it count as an official act, meaning he couldn't be prosecuted for it, he said it would depend on the circumstances. I mean, what circumstances warrant a president ordering the military to stage a coup?
Well, first of all, I did say it depends on the circumstances, so that opens up a whole lot of avenue for context
smart.
But more importantly, Caitlin, he's just saying that would count as an official act.
But could I finish the answer
to the question, Caitlin? An official act, there are a number of checks and balances in our system. There's the impeachment process. There's the budgeting authority that Congress has. There are a number of ways where Congress has a check and balance control over the President of the United States. All he's saying is that the criminal liability procedures that exist in this country don't cover the president's official acts. And by the way, how could anybody disagree with that, Caitlin? Should Barack Obama be prosecuted for killing an American citizen via a drone strike? There are a number of examples in American history where if you apply the standard, the lawfare standard of the Biden administration against Donald Trump, it would make the presidency impossible to actually execute the law.
Yeah,
so in the name of taking down their political opponent, Caitlin, these guys are really pushing a legal theory that I think would destroy the presidency, whether a Democrat or Republican was in charge.
Well, I don't think Jack Smith is running for office. But on what you're saying, you're basically saying that if the president orders the military to stage a coup, you believe the only remediation for that is that he can be impeached or that Congress can restrict the budget?
Well, Caitlin, first of all, you're dealing with hypotheticals here that are completely outside the bounds of this particular situation. Donald Trump did not order a coup, despite the fact that a lot of media people say that he did on January the 6th. He encouraged people to protest peacefully. And of course, most people on January 6th did protest peacefully. What I'm saying is that you have to have some measure of liability for the official acts of the presidency of the United States. And the way to create a check and balance on that system is what the Constitution prescribes here. You can't have prosecutors, many of whom, of course, are deeply embedded with the Democratic Party, trying to destroy the life of a former president who's now running for president because they think that they have a better argument for what that president should have done. You can have a political disagreement with Donald Trump, and that's totally reasonable. You shouldn't destroy the presidency in the process.
Okay.
And I think that's what a lot of the Biden administration Department of Justice is trying
to do.
But
you essentially are agreeing that the presidents should not be able to be prosecuted. Let me ask you something else, because as I mentioned, there is an open question of who Donald Trump will pick to be his vice presidential candidate. We just heard him talking about Marco Rubio. You're hosting a fundraiser with him in your home state of Ohio later this month. I know you say that you two haven't discussed the vice presidency directly, but you said you'd certainly be open to it if he did offer it to you. Considering that, does it give you any pause whatsoever about taking that job when you see how he treated his last vice president?
Well, Caitlin, first of all, again, I haven't talked to Donald Trump about becoming vice president. I think it's important to support President Trump as Republicans because I think he was a good president. And I think that he made the country more prosperous. And I think he made the world more peaceful. What gives me pause, Caitlin, is another 4 years of Biden's administration where he's opened the borders and where you have effectively a conflict, a major world conflict in nearly every continent in the world.
But my question was not about President Biden. It's about President Trump.
Well, look, it's fundamentally about President Biden, because if you're comparing the two records of these presidents and asking, who do I want to be president? It's very clearly that I want Donald Trump to be president. And I understand that there are a lot of things that people like you disagree that he did. But I think fundamentally, he was a good president. He accomplished a lot for the country. And the question fundamentally for our country is, do we want four more years of Joe Biden, or do we want four more years of the peace and prosperity of Donald Trump? That, to me, is an easy question.
The last time I checked, President Biden wasn't approving of the chance to hang his vice president and did not call his vice president when their life was in danger on Capitol Hill, something that Mike Pence himself has testified to. So my question is, does it give you any pause to be his vice president, given how he has treated Mike Pence?
Caitlin, I'm extremely skeptical that Mike Pence's life was ever in danger. I think politics and politics people like to really exaggerate things from time to time.
I know Mike a lot of Pence folks in the Democratic Party.
A lot of folks in the Democratic Party, Caitlin, act as if January the 6th was the scariest moment of their lives. I think, look, January 6th was a bad day. It was a riot. But the idea that Donald Trump endangered anyone's lives when he told them to protest peacefully, it's just absurd. And the entire legal basis of this prosecution of Donald Trump from Jack Smith.
But they were chanting that they wanted to hang him.
Look, Caitlin, did a few people say some bad things? Sure, but do we blame Donald Trump for every bad thing that's ever been said by a participant in American democracy? I think that's an absurd standard. And look, Caitlin, I know you're worried, and I think justifiably so, about
threats to American— This isn't about me, Senator. I'm asking questions about you and how you would feel about this.
I'm trying to answer the question. I appreciate it if you let me. We know that there are threats to American democracy. I think the biggest threat to American democracy, Caitlin, is that the Biden administration is trying to prevent Donald Trump from campaigning and taking his case to the American people,
they hide their own candidate. That's presiding over that case. The Biden administration is not preventing Donald Trump from campaigning. He just did two campaign events tonight.
This is a really important point, Caitlin. Who is the number three person from the Biden Department of Justice who went to work for the New York prosecutor just months before he brought this case against Donald Trump? You can't have people moving from the Biden administration to prosecute Donald Trump in New York and say—
Okay, this was really, really good. It's not a full-length video. This is the highest it is. I love this man. He is really, really clever. If you listen to how he answers the questions, like, he's speaking out from a smart man. He's very, very, very smart. J.D. Vance, I'm really happy he's running, he's the vice president. I'm really happy Trump picked him, because Trump picked a right man who is ready to stand for Republican and also defend Trump no matter what it takes. I love how he answered her question. No matter how she's directing it to him in a negative way, he's giving it back to her in a positive answer. Like, he's really smart at taking off the garbage that people say bad about Donald Trump and putting it to them that this is the reason why he acts this way. This is who Donald Trump really is. And that itself speaks more of a man of integrity and someone who ought to be our VP. I am very, very happy that Donald Trump picked J.D. Vance as the vice president. He is the right candidate. There's not anyone who's going to tell me, because this man is the right candidate. I was really impressed watching the video right now. I am very, very, very impressed. It was a marine. Oh, he's a marine. And his sense of intelligence is something that marvels me. Like, the way he answers questions, the way he talks... The way he give it back to, like, sometimes all those press people, like this colonist, this woman, she's asking him the question in a twisted manner, and he understands such and is able to, like, correct the twist to make it straight for her to get it. Like, she was like, okay, that is true. She was agreeing with all his answers. Like, whenever she's talking bad about him, about Donald Trump, he turns back to her that Donald Trump is a really good man. Especially when she asks him a question about Donald Trump, former VP. Is he not scared? Instead of her, he's not scared. He turned the question back to Biden. If you had to choose between Donald Trump and Biden, who is he going to choose? He feel like Donald Trump is the best candidate. Like, he does not answer her question directly. He gives her the answer in a precise manner. Because she's twisting the questions for him to be like, he's kind of like confused. Well, he's really, really smart. He's very, very smart. Even if she's trying to override him while talking, she's talk over him. But he's like, nah. Can you allow me to speak? He's a really clever man. That itself speaks more of him. I am really, really happy Donald Trump picked him as a VP, because he's someone who's high intellect and very precise in his speaking. This was really beautiful watching this video. Comment down below and think about this video. Subscribe to the channel. Make sure you guys support Republican. I heard the debates coming up very soon. Hope you are ready to watch it. I am fully ready. September 10th by 9 p.m. Eastern time. This is going to be amazing. Hope you guys are excited for this one, because we are all voting and rooting for Donald Trump. Comment down below and think about this video. Give us a thumbs up. Share this video to as many as you can. I will see you guys in our next video. Make sure you stay safe. I just want a bag like an old lady. I'm backwoods smoking. I don't know papers. Pass that 808. That dump shaker. Oh, bitch, you know I'm grinding like a pro skater. Baby mama bugging. I'm so quick to hit ignore. Buku bitch, just in my bed. I got scales on.